Inequations questions based on signs. The basics are positive times positive is positive, negative times negative is positive times negative is negative, positive raised to power even is positive raised to power odd is also positive, negative raised to power even is positive, and negative raised to power odd is negative. Very basic stuff, and beautiful questions can be made based on this concept. Let us take one explanatory example. You may want to pause the video and solve these yourself. Four cases, and these are the answer choices. In these maybe cases, we just need one case to prove each of the statement as correct. See, we want x square to be greater than x cube, and therefore we can imagine negative values. For negative values, x square will be positive, x and x cube would be smaller, and then we also want that x cube is greater than x, and therefore if x is a big negative value such as negative 2, x cube will not be greater than x. We have to look at a small negative value such as a negative 0.5. Imagine x square will be 0.25, x cube will be negative 0.125, a smaller negative number compared to x itself, which is a relatively bigger negative number. So for a case such as x is equal to 0.5 negative, the first case applies, and therefore first statement is correct. Look at the second one now. We want x raised to power 4 to be the greatest, greater than x square. So virtually this part is the same, it's just that x raised to power 4 should be greater than x square. And you will see that in a case such as negative 0.5, which worked in the first statement, will no longer work because x raised to power 4 will be a very small number. It will be 0.0625, which will not be greater than positive 0.25. So there is no value of x for which statement 2 can be correct. This can be eliminated. Look at statement 3 now. We want x raised to power 4 to be the greatest, then x square, and then x cube. This is easy. For a big negative value such as x is equal to minus 2, imagine x raised to power 4 will be 16, x square will be 4, and x cube would be negative. So this is definitely possible. 2 is gone, so option 5 can be eliminated. 1 and 3 are correct. 3 is correct, so A can be eliminated. 1 is correct, so C can be eliminated. 1 is correct, so B can also be eliminated. We have the right answer here. D is the right answer. But just for conceptual clarity, let's look at this one as well. So this would also be true for a case such as x is equal to minus 2. You will see x raised to power 4 will be a big positive number, 16. X square will be a relatively smaller positive number, positive 4. X will be a small negative number, minus 2. And x cube will be a big negative number, negative 8. So for a case such as x is equal to minus 2 or minus 3, big negative numbers, even statement 4 would be correct. The right answer is option D. And there is a lot to be learned from this particular question. Please make sure that you imbibe these concepts. Very, very important on GMAT. This was the concept, guys. GMAT shorts are deliberately kept brief. For an elaborate explanation, please refer the stage 1 videos. Thanks for watching.